Y'all know what's on, right? Hello.
What do you do?
What's up? Welcome to the Girls Room Podcast. I'm Lex.
And I am B, and this is From the West Side with Love, where we not only talk about the streets, but we leave you with a little bit of love. You both did it.
We should be proud of me.
Yeah, you've been doing good these last couple episodes.
It only took me like 10 episodes, but
right,
I got it right.
She got it right, y'all. Finally.
Yeah. Time for...
Bring them out.
You feel me?
All right, y'all. So today, I'm going to bring them out. We have a viral wine. I guess it's a viral TikTok wine. I tasted one of them for the first time last week. And then I remembered that it was a viral TikTok.
Them TikTok.
Y'all be on the TikTok. It was a TikTok viral wine that I saw last year. And this was actually on my list. So it's called XXL. The alcohol percentage is 16%. And we got the mango.
Yeah, we about to be a little slit, so bear with me.
Right, I'm scared. I ain't had the mango. I tasted a little bit of the pineapple last week. And y'all, that was liquor. That wasn't a wine. That was liquor.
So we gonna see.
Okay, you ready? I'm a little nervous. I ain't never nervous to drink no wine. Mm-hmm.
Our cups do not be clinking for right. This good. It smells good too.
But it's good. This is better than the pineapple.
I'm actually scared to like keep sipping this.
Right, because it's going to have you drunk. I feel like it's going to be drunk because it's a good taste. So you'll keep sipping on it.
All right, I'm going to put it down. Oh. Uh-huh. That's not wine. That's liquor.
You know what's crazy? I haven't seen it in a grocery store. I got that from the liquor store.
They might be trying to trick me.
In wine season.
It is good though. It tastes nice. So I can see how you kind of get a little drunk because it tastes good and it's wine. So you're going to finish it fast. And then you'll be drunk. But you know how people don't drink just one glass of wine for real?
Right. We be underestimating wine sometimes.
I believe so. Okay. I don't really drink wine like that, honestly.
I love a good glass of wine, especially with dinner.
Like when I stay by myself, mm-hmm. I never had wine in the house.
I always had wine in the house.
I like fake wine. I like the wine that people be saying is fake wine. The sweet stuff. The stuff that tastes like juice.
Oh, yeah.
I think alcohol is nasty. Anything that's alcoholic is disgusting to me. Unless it tastes like juice.
Mm-mm. You might as well go drink some juice.
Or I could taste liquor. I mean, I could drink liquor that tastes like juice so I can get drunk, but still
have your taste buds. Yeah. I guess. I like to taste a little liquor. I don't know why. Is it weird? It's disgusting. Do I have an addiction?
No.
I'm not addicted, y'all.
Some people don't think liquor is nasty. Like, some people don't.
Yeah, a lot of people be.
Yeah.
I feel like I like
liquor less than other people. Like, I don't like the taste.
You're not your normal liquor liker.
I guess. Because I'd be like.
Mm-mm.
Gotta get prepared. Hold on. Taking deep breaths and shit.
Don't let her fool y'all, though, but she be taking shots.
Because I'm a jerk, though. I'm going to take my shot.
When we was in Miami on the boat, you talking some. Okay, well, y'all should have said. I'm like, yeah. I ain't took now. Because now I'm shy.
We was on this boat to get drunk.
Yeah.
And
it took
us. We finna get drunk.
We didn't even start drinking until an hour in, yeah, I feel like.
We was trying, y'all, we was, okay. First of all, how you been?
Right.
It's the way you just cut it. First of all,
how you been?
We could have started a whole conversation.
Right. I've been good, trying not to get overwhelmed like I predicted in the last episode, and I feel it, but I just got to work on my time management with everything I got. April is going to be a big month already. Did I already handle one No. One event, no.
That's not funny. No.
It's the fifth day of April.
Yeah, and she ain't.
And I think I already accomplished half the stuff I had to.
I didn't even accomplish one thing.
We're not even there yet.
Dang.
To some of the stuff.
Why did I think it was the second week of April already? It's the wine already.
Don't try to blame it on the wine.
Right. Yeah, so I'm just trying to alleviate any type of anxiety or overwhelmingness, if that's a word.
I feel it.
Yeah, but other than that, I've been good. Just trying to. I need to get back on my ashwagandha every day.
Girl, me too.
Yeah.
But honestly, I feel like you get too used to it sometimes. You know?
No. I do. I feel all right. I ain't working
ashwagandha, long. When I tell you ashwagandha will have. I got into an argument because I was on ashwagandha and I was just like, what's wrong with you?
Why you say, we stay on ashwagandha like it's a drug. Y'all, ashwagandha is a natural supplement.
Yeah. It helps you.
It helps to balance.
If you have problems with like anxiety and
stress,
stuff like that,
yeah, it helps really well.
I'm telling you.
How have you been feeling?
I'm good, actually.
It's good.
I have been a little, I don't want to say overwhelmed, but I had got down real bad last week.
Mm-hmm.
Just because what I'm trying to do is just taking me longer than I had ever expected.
Mm-hmm.
And it makes, you know, sometimes you get kind of discouraged, I guess, or just
all the time.
Yeah. So I've had that feeling, but other than that, I've been like,
gotta have some pep talks. You gotta be like Issa.
Get
in the bathroom and start rapping to yourself.
I was in the car and I was praying. I pray. First of all, I love praying in the car. Mm-hmm. I don't know why. Praying in the car, like being in the car and praying, is just like therapeutic.
I don't know. That's my safe space, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
So like, I was praying in the car and I was talking to myself out loud and I was just like, God, I really don't feel like you brought me all the way here to just drop me off and that's it. Like, I really feel like if I wasn't supposed to be doing this, something would have happened a long time ago to, like, disrupt this whole thing.
Yes,
so,
girl. Be vulnerable with him.
I really was trying to, like, talk myself, really remember that I ain't come this far from nothing.
Exactly.
You know, I really just don't feel like that because it's been other things in my life to where I wanted to do this and then eventually something happened to make that not be something that I can even do anymore.
Focus on it at that
right.
Moment.
So I just don't feel like if I wasn't supposed to be doing this, something would have been happened.
Yeah.
To push me in a different direction.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah.
Yeah, because you're almost at the finish line with it.
And I need to be done.
That's the thing about it. But you know what they always say.
Because after I'm done.
When you get closest to the finish line, that's when you be feeling like giving up. But that's how you know everything that you need is about to happen.
Like when I tell you, I was going to be like, okay, fuck it. Like, fuck it then. Let me find something else to do.
Right.
Like, or like now, just fuck it.
Mm-hmm. You too close. You got one more step. It's going to come. In God's timing.
Yeah, I know y'all feel like that sometimes, but y'all better be on your easy way talking to yourself in the mirror.
Y'all gotta
copy yourself up, because shit ain't easy, and I feel like it's very easy to get discouraged, especially when it takes longer than you expect, or things are not going like how you wanted them to go. Like, factors always, like, shit always go at it. So, you just gotta remember through that shit, you gonna be okay, and if you wasn't supposed to be doing this, God will let you know.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah,
exactly. He wouldn't take you to it if he wasn't gonna take you through it, honey.
Girl, I like that.
Cool.
What's in your rotation?
Oh, honey, this has just been an eventful week when it comes to music. Well, 2 weeks. So last week, of course, I was listening to Beyonce.
Mm-hmm.
That's my big sister. Her and Solange is my big sister. I'm the baby of the family. Yumby. Well, anyways,
yeah,
Lil B. I was listening to her for the past week. What's the name of the album? Cowboy Carter.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. My favorite song off of there is Levi Jeans. I just love that song so much. Oh my God. It just made me want to take a glass of wine and be dancing around the house in my Levi Jeans with my man rubbing all up on me.
Oh, that's cute.
It's so cute. It's such a cute song. And then, of course, we done listened to Metro Boomin and Future. Mm-hmm. Especially like that. And today, I listened to the whole album, but I feel like I need a 2-3 more listens so I can get more accustomed to the songs. But it just dropped today, J. Cole, new project. Mm-hmm. I do have a favorite song off of there already. HYB, Hide Your Bitch. That's a nice little tune. Listen to it, girl. Got to play it in rotation.
I listened to the whole album, mm-hmm. but I definitely need to.
Yeah. Besides, you know, the last track, we already know what that one about.
Right, because I listened to that one first.
Right, I did too. Definitely did too. So it's been in your rotation. I know I just said a whole list of stuff.
I actually just finished. Well, I haven't finished listening to Beyonce album. It was long.
It is long.
So I haven't finished listening to it yet. I'm halfway, so I gotta finish. I have been listening to Future though. Future and Metro Boomin. My favorite song off that album right now is Type Shit. Mm-hmm. That's my shit.
That's such a vibe.
And of course I listened to J. Cole today. Cause who didn't?
Right.
If you didn't, you should've.
Right, you're missing out. Yeah. That's not one of the ones that you know, wait a couple days.
No, that was to listen to J. Cole.
That was a surprise
day.
Drop.
Right, because I was like, what happened?
And then it's Dreamville weekend. That shit was fire.
He turned up with that.
He did.
I said, okay.
Yeah,
you did your thing. I wonder if he's going to perform any of his new songs at Dreamville.
Maybe. I can see it.
Yeah.
Because he know people going to be got that in rotation for sure the whole weekend. Right.
Yeah,
I think it's going to be lit.
But that's cool, though, because he, like, Dreamville this weekend, he gave them something. So, you know what I'm saying?
Right. And honestly, I can't say that right now. We're going to talk about that later. But, yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Yeah. Is it our favorite time?
It is the time.
You go first. Out the coupe at the lot. Turn the fuck 12, fuck SWAT. Busting all the bells out the box.
I hope I get something good. Habitual liars. We hate them.
We've experienced them.
If you're a habitual liar, I don't even know you, but I hate you.
Every time I think of that word, this one particular person comes in mind every time.
Same.
And everybody that I know that knows him, all agree. This man is a habitual liar.
Same.
Y'all.
And niggas just, and it can be females as well. But
yes, because I done met some females that be liars. I hate when females be like trying to lie about things that happen to them in life to make them feel like their life is just so much better than other people's.
Yes.
That's annoying as fuck. But niggas be lying. What did you call it? What is a habitual liar? When they just make up lies
and they just lie, unsolicited lies.
Like, literally, nobody even asked you about that, and you just started talking.
I call it volunteering lies.
Yes, voluntary.
So you just came to me and said, "Hey," and then spit out lies to my mouth. Something nobody asked you about. You just went to lie. Like, what is wrong with you?
Niggas is weird.
People are some fucking weirdos.
Like, what?
I remember when we was in high school, I remember this. It was like two of them.
I was just about to say one of them stories.
They used to be lying.
This girl used to be lying. We had two female friends.
And both of them were like the biggest fucking liars. Like, why the fuck are you lying so much?
And I'd be looking at them on social media and I'd just be like, I wonder if you still be lying.
Literally. I wonder if you're still a fucking liar. Mm-hmm. Being a liar has to be like... Like, once somebody finds out that you're a liar...
You can't believe nothing else they say.
Literally, like, that is it for you.
Right.
Like, you're done.
You're done.
You're done.
I don't believe nothing you say. You can say... your favorite color red. I'm gonna be like, no, the fuck is not.
It is not. Your favorite color is probably fucking blue.
Right.
And you sitting up here fucking lying because you're a weirdo.
Just like you lied that your daddy had got you a car and it only stay at his house when your daddy ain't get you no car. I don't even know if you know your goddamn daddy. But you just lying. Weird.
Why would your daddy buy you a car?
And he can only stay at his house.
And you ain't driving it.
And you live with your mama. You go to school on your mama's side of town. You think your mama want to get up and take you to school every day?
And you was when very you got a car much your daddy house? Old enough to drive. It's not like we was like permit age. No, we was the driver's license age.
Right. Like, girl, get it together.
Please.
Not everything you say is a lie to me.
And I know a dude that's a habitual liar. When I tell y'all, this man will lie about anything. If he go outside and the sky look anything other than what it normally look like, it don't even have to. He gonna go outside and he gonna look up and he gonna come back in and say, the sky is red. And I'm gonna be like,
no, it ain't. He gonna be like, yes, it is.
Like, yes, it is. Bro, this nigga lie about a fucking screenshot. The same thing happened. I have the evidence, and you're still sitting here lying?
I should smack the shit out of you.
I should take this phone and knock your ass upside the head.
Literally, because are you, like, why would you still lie through the truth? Like, I know the truth now. Just let it go. Just literally, drop it.
The same thing but happened you
got,
to me.
He got a, they be holding on like a dog with a fucking bone, bro.
Literally. That should be so. I would never forget this. I saw, I had proof the proof was in the pudding. Man. I screenshotted it and sent it to him. I said, I know you still X, Y, and Z because your mama posted you X, Y, and Z-ing. Oh, no. That's just because what? Because you are X, Y, and Z-ing, nigga. It's right there. Can you not see it?
Yeah.
You think I'm stupid.
I sent a screenshot of what exactly I knew, and this motherfucker was like, nah, that was old.
Then it be having a timestamp on it. That was old.
Nah, oh,
it was
old.
Yesterday old.
That was
okay.
Old, bitch.
Why you still stop bringing up old shit? That's what he was saying.
Stop. Just cut it the fuck out. Yeah, I don't like liars. People that lie for, like, especially if you just volunteer lies. Like, if you just voluntarily come up to me and say, hey, it's just so dumb.
No, I have one. I will give y'all an example. I hope this nigga watching it too.
Jesus.
So, I was talking to this dude. Mm-hmm. And I don't even know if I invited him over or he just invited himself over. I can't even fucking remember. Okay. But I was already in the bed, not even worried about this man. I'm in the bed watching my little shows, just chilling. I hear a knock at my door. It gotta be this nigga, because who else is it gonna be?
Yeah.
When I tell y'all, this man opened his door and said, and it was late as fuck too. It was like 1:00 or 2:00 in the morning. This man came to my house and said, because I do not even remember inviting this man over. That's why I was like, what are you doing? He said, I would have been here earlier, but I think he had the wrong bitch. I don't know. He said, I would have been here earlier, but I almost got robbed selling some shoes.
I remember that.
At West End. One thing, this nigga not from here.
So what the hell you in the West End for?
You have no business doing the West End.
Especially not making no transactions. You tripping.
You really green.
As fuck.
So I don't even know why you even leave your house at this time to go to West End to sell some shoes. And then to say almost got robbed. If you was making a transaction in West End and a nigga tried you, it wasn't going to be an almost. That nigga was robbing you.
Like, no almost, baby.
So you came up in here looking fine and dandy, but he gonna start breathing hard and shit. I'm just like, nigga, West End like 20 minutes from here. It's I'm thinking you done caught your fucking breath by now.
Girl, he ran all the way. He ran. He was.
Oh, you went in the car. Can't catch my breath. And how the fuck did you get away? That's what I want to know.
You could have said down the street at a gas station or something.
And I'm just sitting here looking at him like this.
And he can tell I'm not believing nothing he's saying. But my thing is, I don't know if you came in here thinking I was about to question you. My question was going to be, why the fuck are you here? I think he had got the wrong bitch that time.
He was supposed to be at somebody else's house. He like, he knew that you didn't invite him over there. So he like, I got to find a way to get in this
I'm panicking. Like, you have to be my emotional support now.
I got to find a way to get in this motherfucker. Because if I don't, she probably going to send me to my ass home.
And I was thinking, please go fucking home. Please go the fuck home.
I hate niggas. I just hate lying ass people. People, period. Just stop all that fucking lying. Like, and some people just lie because they scared to be themselves.
Yeah. They're not comfortable in who they are, and they don't. Some people don't think it's enough. Like, I'm okay with my little simple stuff that I got going on.
I'm fine.
Like, back when I was in high school, I was okay with my simple life. No, I did not have a car.
So yes. Damn, then
my mama or my sister.
I didn't even have no cell phone half the time. Like, what the fuck?
Yes, I was riding Martyr to school if my mama or my sister couldn't take me. Okay with it. I'm not saying, oh, yeah, y'all, my step parents got me a Benz at their house in Douglasville, but I can't drive right now.
Yeah.
That don't make no damn sense.
I wasn't trying to impress nobody.
Right.
Who the fuck I want to impress?
It's crazy.
Yeah, I don't know. That's weird. Anyways, all right. Next.
Don't be a liar.
Don't be a freaking liar, man. It's whack.
Oh, shit. Because one is happening right now. Mercury retrograde.
Whoa! We are in PSA. Mercury is in microbraids.
And them bitches is... Well, I don't know if they're going to be as
tight. Right now.
They wasn't tight as they was back in December, honey.
Baby.
They was snatching her baby hairs out that day. Well, that
somebody was whooping Mercury ass. Like, had her by the braids like this. And was... tearing that ass. Because I was not having a good time at all. So if you guys don't know, let's give you the real definition if you don't know what Mercury retrograde is.
Alexis is the one that introduced me to Mercury retrograde because I didn't know what the hell was going on in the universe.
I needed to know what the fuck was going on. Like, shit used to be going fucked up and I used to be like, what in the hell, bro? Like, y'all, literally, stuff used to happen so bad. I remember I had came to the conclusion that I just don't have a good night. I was like, even years are like my bad luck years. I used to feel like that. Because in 2016, y'all, 2016 was a very interesting year. We just gonna say that. I had fun. I ain't gonna care. I had fun. But it also wasn't that great. But then 2017 turned around and was like kind of similar. So then I was like, okay, what the fuck is happening then?
I'm over here thinking, I've never thought of it like that. I think odd years are my bad years. Because 2015 and 2013 was terrible. You just said that.
I see how you used to think that. You can't say that now.
Oh.
You can't think that. Because you're going to make it be like that. That's another reason why I tried to like change my...
Let me not just talk about it then.
Because I don't want to jinx myself. Right. Or I don't want to speak that on
right.
Myself.
So, yeah. Next year. Yeah. Ooh, yeah. But so, I have noticed that.
So, I had to figure it out. I had to figure out what the fuck was going on. And this is what I came up with. Mercury retrograde. Okay? If you are into zodiacs and all that, then you probably already know what Mercury retrograde is. But I'm about to tell you exactly what it is. So basically, let's go. Let's see, y'all. And people look at Mercury retrograde as a bad thing. I will say some bullshit to be happening, but I have created a different take on it in my head. Okay, so. It says Mercury is one of the fastest moving planets in the solar system and goes retrograde occasionally. So basically when it goes retrograde, that means that it's moving backwards. So the orbit moves backwards. and it slows down movements in reality. So it changes a lot for us. So I know one thing that it changes is communication. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of breaks in communication during Mercury retrograde. And one thing that always happens during Mercury retrograde is exes. Exes or like somebody you used to mess with like romantically, even if they weren't like your boyfriend or your girlfriend, they're going to come back. Like somebody, if not multiple people, but somebody is going to come texting you, calling you, trying to follow you on freaking Instagram, like somebody coming. And that's how I always know when Mercury retrograde is coming, because I get that phone call or that text message and I be like, who sent you, Nook?
And isn't another one that affects, doesn't it affect transportation?
It affects like electronics.
Yeah.
So that's why I think, that's why I rolled over my headphones last year. Y'all, last year, Mercury retrograde, me and my headphones, we was battling.
Maybe that's why my computer shut off on me.
It was a fucking battle last year during Mercury retrograde. And I can't remember what month that was, but it was a battle. So this one started on August 1st. Mm. And it ends on August 25th.
April?
But,
April?
Why am I saying August?
Because it's an A.
April 1st. And it ends on April 25th. But there is a pre-shadow and post-shadow period.
I was trying to do the animation.
So, even though it began on April the 1st, it was a brewing like a week and a half before April the 1st. So, it was like, it let you know what was going on. Because the phone call that I got was before April the 1st. So, it was during the pre-shadow period. So, basically, the pre-shadow period is kind of like a...
like PMSing for a cycle.
Basically, yeah. And then the post-shadow period is kind of like a cool down, you know? Mm-hmm. Kind of like a whatever was trying to get you during Mercury retrograde. It's trying to take you out to the end.
Yeah, I feel like last Mercury retrograde, well, I tell you, every man from my past since 2019 was in my DMs, calling me, texting me, doing something. And I'm like, what the fuck is going on here?
I have one ex.
It makes their spidey senses tingle.
That damn near texts me or messages me on Instagram every time we are in Mercury retrograde. I'm actually like very much surprised that he haven't contacted me this time.
Like, is Mercury retrograde, like, does it tingle in the niggas? I don't know.
I think it, so what I think it is, because I've noticed it myself too, and I try not to contact anybody. Mm-hmm. So, like, sometimes I'll think about people.
It's recommended that you don't make any big decisions during Mercury retrograde. Mm-hmm. Do not get back with your ex. Don't do it. Do not do that shit. And Mercury retrograde affects your sign, affects zodiac signs differently, depending on what retrograde we're in. So this one right here probably is affecting Aries and maybe Taurus.
I'm getting it, yeah. So it falls on whatever, whenever the retrograde falls in whatever zodiac sign that is, that's who it's affecting.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the one that passed in December, it affected us a lot.
That was hectic as hell. I would never.
It was crazy. When I say crazy, I mean, and when I say Mercury retrograde affects you, I mean like, everything starts to go wrong sometimes. Like, it will literally feel like your fucking life is falling apart. But I be feeling like,
I'm trying to think what I felt like. I was in shambles, but
I was in shambles in December.
I was definitely in shambles.
In December, all the way up until probably like we moved. Girl, I was in shambles.
Yes.
But it started in December.
Yeah.
It started in December. It was crazy.
I was already in shambles. December just ain't making no damn man, better.
I was the, it started, man, look. But I'll be, now I have started to understand, like, I don't feel like it's, like, people who feel, when Mercury retrograde come, it's not exciting for it to come just because you know, like, some stuff about to happen. Mm-hmm. Like, it might not be big stuff. Like, this one, it might be, this one might be easier.
Yeah, I feel like this is going to be an easy one for some reason. Maybe because I have a lot of positive stuff going on.
Yeah.
To kind of, like, get you away from even putting your energy or thinking about anything bad possibly happen. I think that's what it is.
But I be feeling like a lot of times when Mercury retrograde happen, I don't even think the stuff that happens to me, it ain't even that
something
like
to
I
think
just
of, or you can
right.
try to think.
I broke
that
my fucking
existence.
Toe last year during Mercury retrograde. That I wasn't thinking about shit, but going to see John Wick 4 in the movie theater. The day I broke my toe, I was working from home, and I had bought a ticket to go see John Wick in movie theaters. It was Tuesday. The movie ticket would be like $6. Mm-hmm. So I was like, okay, cool. Normally, I work out after work, but I was like, I'm going to work out on my lunch break today so I can
go get
to the movie on time after work. Baby, I'm working out on my lunch break. A fucking weight fell off the damn rack while I was picking up a weight. The weight next to it falls off the rack onto my fucking toe. It was like a 35-pound weight. That shit fell on my damn toe. And I thought I was finna go to a fucking movie theater. Fuck no.
She couldn't even walk.
Literally.
That ain't funny.
That shit was whack. I was mad as fuck that I wasted my $6 on that fucking movie. Because they wouldn't give me, I couldn't get no
$6 and it wasn't the regular price.
That regular price is not even that fucking high. Oh. But still.
Well, still discounted.
Whack ass shit. But yeah. So, if like it be periods of time in your life where shit just kind of be going crazy, it's probably Mercury retrograde.
Yeah, mine just be like a lot of weird energy coming at me.
Yeah.
Especially from the male species. I don't know why.
Mine be like all kinds of.
In my
different
fucking
shit.
Computer. But I don't know. Because that motherfucker just be fucking up all the time. But the other day, that shit cut off on me and would not turn back on in the middle of my fucking
house.
I was so pissed.
It probably had something to do with Mercury.
Yeah, it was off for like 3 days. And then I just started banging that motherfucker around. And I plugged it in and it started.
Yeah. Because it definitely affects electronics and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. If you traveling, double check all your shit. Like, literally, make sure
your flights don't get delayed.
That flight, right. Like, make sure you own it because Mercury retrograde, like,
will have you missing flights.
Miss a fucking flight, and you're going to be looking sad, looking crazy. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Yeah, when I think of Mercury retrograde coming up, I just be like, oh, it's coming up. I kind of, like, I don't think too hard about it, but I be trying to, like, brace myself. Really, just, like, be cognizant. I know a lot of people don't be believing in the universal energies and stuff, but hey, it ain't no coincidence for no reason,
right? And some people be saying like, oh well, if you believe in that, you're basically like thinking itself, like thinking that
it to exist.
Yeah, like basically, like you, if you thinking about it or you paying attention to it, that's when stuff start happening. I'm like, no, that's not the case, because even before I knew exactly what the fuck Mercury retrograde was. Shit was still happening to me.
Right, because I would be on the phone with you and be like, this, and this happening, and this happening, and I don't understand why. And you'd be like, hold on.
Literally.
It's retrograde.
Because I'm going to stop every time. If somebody tell me too many odd things happen within a certain amount of time, like, too close together, I'm going to be like, hold on. We're going to look at the dates.
Let me go look into my calendar real quick.
It has to be a fucking retrograde. Like, literally. Yep. So, yeah. If y'all didn't know about that, go look it up. I'm telling y'all, this shit has a lot to do with a lot of shit, okay? Seriously. So, yeah.
All right. Next we have is the hot topic. No, trending topic.
And that's a trending topic. Yeah, that's a trending topic.
Trending topic. The rat beef.
Sit my joint.
It's the trending topic now. We was just discussing what we've been listening to and having in rotation, and some of those tracks is what's sparking this rap beef.
The rap beef.
So I'm already knowing y'all heard like that.
I know y'all heard it, and I know y'all seen that man on the stage is acting like he pressed.
Everybody know that Metro Boomin and Future featuring Kendrick Lamar made it a diss track to Drake. And apparently J. Cole too.
Yeah, cause J. Cole has something to say.
And my thing about that whole J. Cole thing is, Kendrick, you kind of dumb as fuck for doing that, because you literally just opened up opportunity for J. Cole to capitalize off this shit. Because it's just like, you know, Dreamville was coming up, nigga. And you thought,
what if it was planned?
You thought J. Cole wasn't gonna pop his shit. This his weekend.
Yeah.
So you dropped this, what, 2 weeks ago? This nigga pulled up. He already had, I'm already sure he had having tracks already ready.
I'm sure.
He did a little tweaking. He said, oh yeah, these niggas ain't about to get me. Fuck that.
And drop that
Not
shit.
Not even a track. He dropped a whole goddamn project on y'all asses to open up his weekend. That's how you fucking shit on somebody, okay?
Man, look.
You was asking for it, Kendrick. Where your project at? You just featured on the song. Everybody talking about Kendrick diss track, Kendrick diss track. That ain't even his song.
It's not.
That's just his verse. Literally. Okay. And K-Dot, you might have to go.
K-Dot gonna have to go in the lab for sure.
J. Cole, we in on your ass. He talked about every project you done dropped.
I said.
In on your ass. But you asked for it because J. Cole was over there chilling. He literally said, don't make me have to do something.
Wait, don't make me have to, because I fuck with this nigga. Because
I fuck with this nigga. Yeah. So really, you just started some shit.
Yeah, because he wasn't even trying to do
some
that.
Type of way. J. Cole probably might have felt
like
his energy
just
before.
To be honest.
Yeah, definitely. But it's just like, Kendrick, you sound like a bitter bitch. I'm sorry. You do.
I mean, hey man, it's rap beef.
It is.
Because Drake been throwing shots at Kendrick forever.
He has, like, but Drake is just so sassy with the way he does his
Drake. Drake. Let's talk about Drake.
He's saying something every night on that damn stage.
He's very pressed. Like, and then it's for me, it's the trying to like act like he above. Like,
but if you were above it,
I'm gonna hold my head high.
But if you were above it, you wouldn't address it.
Literally.
You'll be on tour.
Honestly,
shit,
Drake bothered as hell, because if I was a fucking rapper and some niggas dissed me, I'm not bringing it on my tour. This shit is my, this my shit.
Exactly. I think he's trying to do it because he know that people are expecting him to say something, but that don't mean you gotta fucking say something.
Nigga, you better wait until that tour over and go, well, you better go make a song in the daytime while you ain't
next Friday, he need to be dropping the track just like J. Cole just did.
But yeah, you and then honestly,
drinking
all this shit
and fucking for the tweet and deleter's head ass.
Now I will say, now I finally understand the tweet and deleter's video.
Exactly, because I did not understand it.
Me
at first.
Either.
I'm thinking, you know how Drake is just a natural troll, so I'm thinking he's just trolling on some being funny shit.
I had a feeling Drake was talking to somebody, but I just didn't know who. Like, because he said tweet and deleter's, and I didn't know who tweeted and deleted they shit. Like,
well, you know somebody on the internet called it. Metro Boomin.
Hell yeah. No, I'm saying, like, and then Metro, so first sense. Of all, that tweet and delete shit,
that's sassy in itself. Why the fuck, if you gonna fucking say
stand
it
on that
chest,
shit,
nigga.
If you gonna tweet it, stand on
don't
it.
Don't delete it.
Nigga, why would you tweet something and delete it, knowing how Twitter works? You are fucking famous. You don't think that people get paid to fucking, they, first of all, I'm pretty sure they got your notifications on.
Yeah.
So these people get paid to fucking screenshot your fucking tweets. Let's be serious.
Exactly.
So the delete shit, I kind of felt like that was a little, that was lame in my opinion. Like, for Metro to tweet what he said and delete it, it was lame, but who knows why he deleted this shit? I don't fucking know. It was stupid, though.
And then you still come back up doing a diss track. You should have just kept what you said on
exactly.
the internet.
Exactly. If y'all was going to conspire and diss Drake, then why not have just kept your fucking shit up? Like, but he saw the shit anyway.
Yeah.
So what the fuck, like,
he was gonna see it regardless. Somebody was gonna screenshot this shit and be like, who the fuck is he talking about?
That was interesting. I was like, but what I also thought was interesting was the fact that the same, okay, so apparently there's disses towards Future on, is it Her Loss or Father Dogs?
I feel like
they were saying it was like little sneak disses on Her Loss towards Future,
and that's why they're trying to bring
but Drake was on Future album like 6 months before. It might not have been 6 whole months. It might have been like, nah, it might have been like 5 or 6 months before. Because Drake album dropped, what, May 1st? It was the weekend.
Yep, it was,
wedding.
Yeah, it was
so,
May 1st.
So, May 1st, Future album dropped. And then Drake and 21 dropped, like,
October.
It might have been, no, it was before November. It was like,
September. It was in September.
Like, damn. So, you go from working with this nigga, and you know what I'm saying, to dissing him. By September?
I lied, November.
Of 2022?
Yeah, I was looking at the wrong album. It was November. I was right. Yeah, it was
November. November of 2022.
November 4th.
Damn.
Yup, because that's when we had, yup, we was out of town.
That's crazy. I thought that was interesting, but he did. I think I heard something basically saying, like, I would listen to some shit on TikTok, and it was a verse, a Drake verse from one of his songs, basically kind of saying that niggas was just doing shit like, you know, niggas collabing because they get money. You feel me? But niggas ain't cool for real. And I'm like, damn, that's crazy.
I'm guessing they just looked at that as a business type deal, and it wasn't really no friendship.
But I never, I never thought that Future and Drake would be beefing because they were so cool at one point in time.
Exactly. And they be looking like they be having fun and they be OVO, videos.
OVO, FBG, OVO.
That was so amazing to me. I just thought that was a great collab.
Because what a time.
That was great. That was a great time.
If you weren't there, should have been there.
What a time to be alive.
Man, I love it. What a time to be alive was.
We had fun.
Shit.
We had fun with that.
But I also thought it was interesting that Metro is beefing with, okay. So, if y'all know, if everybody know, Metro and 21 are very close.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. They trying to bring 21 in it.
So, when Metro kind of, like, felt some type of way about her loss, I was like, wait, but your boy on there. Like, that's Drake and your boy album, not just a Drake album. So, for you to kind of feel away, if I was his friend, I'd be like, damn, nigga, you hating?
Exactly. You supposed to be supporting.
Like, you supposed to be my dog, reposting. No matter how much you don't like this nigga.
Right. Well, I don't know. Men act worse than females these days, obviously.
And people keep on saying something about the fact that 21 ain't said nothing. But I feel like 21 don't need to
that
say
ain't
nothing.
His beef.
It's not his, you know what I'm saying?
Say
it's not his
either.
Issue.
Get
so,
the fuck out my
yeah,
face.
Yeah, I wouldn't say nothing either. Yeah, because they was, the other day when Metro had tweeted and said something about a nigga scared to post the album. Everybody was like, oh, he was talking about 21. And I'm like,
probably, but nigga, you still be, you was tweeting and deleting, so shut the fuck up. That
but
don't make it no better.
I wouldn't post that fucking album, to be honest. Like, you could be my homie all you want to be, but I'm getting money with this nigga. Like, I ain't finna fuck up with my my money, what I got going
and
on.
Obviously,
I'm trying to
it
be cool
like
with you.
They won't got a better friendship than whatever the fuck Drake had with Future and them any fucking way.
I think it's
because
like
when
the
I
same.
Be watching his interviews, Future and 21 really fuck with each other.
Yeah,
I mean not Future, Drake and 21 really fuck with each other.
But it seemed like Drake and Future did too.
They seemed like they was like
besties. So yeah, but that shit been very entertaining. This shit is very entertaining.
We ain't had no entertainment like that since Tupac.
Cause Cole came out swinging.
And I was a child.
He said, "Oh, this nigga got something to say." All right.
It's funny because when I first heard his voice on track, I was like, "Damn, what the fuck he been?"
No, seriously.
I don't think them the type of niggas that do any type of drive-bys or nothing like that.
Who them?
Oh yeah. Nah. You know how the old rap.
Yeah,
because
the old rappers
nigga,
that should have turned into real beef.
Studio real quick.
Nigga, that should have turned into real beef and niggas be dropping like flies and shit.
These niggas.
But I
pretty.
Feel like this right now is just like rap beef.
Yeah.
Like I think they just gonna be. I mean, no rap. Granted, they really are beefing. Like
yeah.
Them niggas don't fuck with each other.
They don't.
But
it's funny.
It will not escalate to no real beef.
You can
but
tell
honestly,
nobody's taking it serious.
Drake not like that anyway.
Exactly.
Like. I mean, they said he ain't like that. They knew he wasn't like that. He not.
Aubrey from Canada is not like that.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Hey, that's why the song is called like that.
Yeah.
Anyways. Let's get into the streets.
She belongs to the street. All right. So, our streets topic for today is, do you go through your significant other's phone?
My answer is no. And two reasons why. First reason is, I just feel like if you're in a solid relationship.
Jesus.
Daddy and your baby. If you are in a solid relationship, you shouldn't even have a reason to want to go through your significant other's phones. And that's just that. It's just like, if y'all are so open, you have so much trust and honesty within each other, then it's really no point. Like, and I've been on both sides. Well, not on both sides, but I've been in relationships where it was some iffy stuff going on and I still didn't go through that phone. And it's been a relationship where we were so solid, I didn't have no reason to go through the phone, and I didn't desire to go into the phone. And that actually felt good. I think my last relationship was like one of the one relationships that I had that I never thought to even think in my mind was in that phone type of thing. But I've been in relationships where I've already had it in the back of my mind, but I still didn't do it. I just can't come to terms with doing that. Just going into somebody's phone. And because especially if you're already speculating something, you're going to go and find exactly what you were looking for.
And then what you're going
to
do.
Exactly. But also, sometimes you have to just not play a role, but you have to keep it cool because and just have faith that if something is happening, pray about that. If something is happening, it's going to come to light and God is going to remove you from that situation. And that's exactly what happened to me in my situation when I felt like uneasy in the relationship, but I didn't take the actions of going through phones, checking this, checking that. And I honestly didn't desire to do that because I was scared of what I was going to see. Mm-hmm. But then I kind of just let it go. I've always had the I kept the speculation in the back of my mind, but I kind of let it go when it came to like us being together, mm-hmm. you know, the upfront stuff. I just kind of let it coast, but it came to light. Like, I did not ask for this, and it came. No, I asked. I prayed to God because I was feeling uneasy in a relationship. I did not take my own action of going through phones. But I prayed to God. I said, if this man is not for me, please show me and remove him from my life. I feel like something is wrong. Something is not going well right here, and I don't know what it is, Lord. But if it's something I need to see, show it to me. And y'all, like 2 days later, I think, it came out. Like, I had his phone in my hand, but I was not trying to go through it. I was moving it. It was on my side of the bed, and I said, "Hun, get your phone." And what? It just started ringing in my hand, and it was this female, one in particular female that was calling him at 3-4 o'clock in the morning. And that put it in. That's all I needed to know. Picked up that phone, and it was all she wrote. Everything came out. Everything came out.
That's crazy.
Yep. So, no, I don't go through phones, even when I have the desire.
Well, I hate that we be agreeing on every fucking thing. But I don't go through phones either. My reasons are a little different, though. I don't go through phones because you want to, I just personally feel like sometimes I don't care. And also, I do be feeling like if something is supposed to be shown to me, it's going to be shown. Like, I don't have to go through your phone to find out what I need to find out. I'm the type of bitch to find out some shit through a dream. I swear to God. I'm not playing. Like, I'm the type of person that will find out some shit through a fucking dream and wake up acting a damn fool. Because why did that happen in my dream? Right. If it's not happening in real life, then why the fuck did this shit happen in my dream? Like, I'm so sick. And I be
looking like, damn.
Baby, I be dead ass serious about them fucking dreams. You know, I started with my ex. Like, I started with him, like, several times about a fucking dream. Really? And he used to be like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Okay, so did they have anything to do with the waking life?
I think that I was dreaming certain stuff, certain things I would dream. So I try to remember that sometimes you dream about stuff because you might be thinking about it before you fall asleep. But sometimes you dream about stuff because something is trying to be revealed to you. Yeah.
But best believe, a girl gonna find out some shit for sure. Like, but I feel like not even a girl, everybody. That's why I don't be, I try my best not to lie. I don't got caught in a couple lies. And that's dumb. Like, I'd be like, oh, why did I even do that? Like, why did I even lie? Because I knew that the truth was gonna come out. Y'all, and the way I got caught in the lies, I told on myself by mistake.
How the hell you do that, bro?
Because he asked me about the lie again, and I forgot I lied the first time. So I didn't lie the second time, and he was like, well, this is what you said the first time. I was like,
I would have been looking at your ass like you was crazy, too. Because what the fuck?
I can't lie. So well, after that, I was just like, yeah, I'm going to just not do that no more because I can't keep up with no freaking lies.
I have a question.
Okay.
Has somebody ever gone through your phone?
Yes. Okay. So, but this was when I was young. Okay, no. I'm trying to think. Did that boy go to my phone? I went through his phone. I have gone through one person's phone. And when I went through that phone, I didn't go through the phone like, oh, I know he doing something. I don't know what he doing. I went through his phone already kind of feeling like, I went through his phone on some, let me see. Yeah, like, I wanted to see what he really be. Like, I knew it was some bullshit, but I wanted to see how bullshit was the bullshit.
The bullshit it was.
I remember going, this nigga fell asleep. We came to your dorm when you stay at Clay State. When y'all stay, it was you and in the four.
Mm-hmm.
We came there and they fell asleep. Well, him and his homeboy fell asleep. And
they was with you?
Uh-huh.
Child,
they came with me.
Y'all got bad memory. We're gonna talk about that later.
I remember the fact that I guessed his fucking phone password. Cause niggas are so fucking stupid. Y'all do dumb ass shit like 1, 2, 3, 4. Like,
yeah.
Let's be serious. So I tried probably like 3 times before I guessed the password. It was straight down the middle.
Oh no, that was dumb
as hell. So I guessed the phone password and I was scrolling through, and I see everything that I imagined to see. Like,
and I just locked the phone and I went through it.
Like, I really just went through his phone. Like, you know, a lot of girls go through phones because they want to see if they nigga doing something.
Yeah.
I went through his phone because I wanted to be nosy.
Yeah, you just curious.
I was just curious and I wanted to see what was going on, but I knew it. I expected to see that. You feel me? But I remember I was a teenager and this boy, I ain't gonna cap. Some of the stuff that I went through in my adult dating life is karma from when I was a teenager. I'm not even playing because I used to be doing, y'all, I used to be doing some bullshit when I was a teenager. Oh, my God. Oh, my Jesus Christ. But this boy who used to stay in my neighborhood, we used to talk. And I remember one time he asked me, he was like, let me go through your phone. And I was like, okay. So I just handed him the phone. Like, I'm that type of person. You want to go through my phone? Here you go. Whatever you see, that's what you see. Okay, and if I'm not your girlfriend, you cannot. I don't want to hear nothing.
Pick your poison. Mm-hmm.
But I don't be going through phones because I really do feel like shit is going to reveal itself to you. And also, if I start asking to go through a nigga phone, he going to start asking to go through my phone. And regardless, if it might not. Like, if this my man, there's nothing in his phone. Like, he literally can, like, have his phone whenever he wants to. But it's just the principle of, like, we not finna do that.
Yeah.
All that untrust, like, yeah, because if it feels like there's no trust in this,
why are we
together? I don't want to be here.
Why are we together?
So I've always said, if I feel like I gotta go through a nigga phone, I'm out. Like, the moment I feel like I gotta go through your phone because you acting weird or it's something going on to the point where I feel like you hot as shit, then I'm gonna just wrap it the fuck up.
I'm gonna bounce.
Yeah, big, wrap it up.
Bounce out there, bitch.
Wrap it crazy. Up. I feel like going through phones is toxic.
It is.
Yeah.
Just be prepared.
But also, if I go through that phone, if I purposely say, hand me your phone and I go through and I find something,
ain't finna be like you dum-dums. I ain't staying. I'm getting a fuck
and
on.
That's the thing about it. They cry about it, yell about it, scream about it, but then still stay.
Are that's another reason stupid? Why I don't go through phones, because I don't want to go through the phone just to find something, cry, and stay.
Exactly.
That's I'm not dumb. Staying. I'm gone. Well, I'd rather be oblivious.
If you're going to go through somebody's phone, be prepared for whatever it is that you find. But don't be a dumbass and stay.
Right.
If you, I feel like if I'm going through somebody's phone, the purpose of me going through this phone is to see, like, what I need to see so I can get the fuck.
Right. And then even if I, regardless of the way I find out, if I find out some shit, I'm not going to stay, because that's still going to be this. Well, another reason why I don't double back. That shit is still going to be in my mind. Like I said, when I found out he was cheating on me through that phone, and he came and tried to talk, we tried to talk about it, I couldn't get the fact that you was cheating on me this whole time out my fucking mind. No, I cannot be back in a relationship with you, because that shit is constantly in my mind. That's now it. I'm going to be looking at who doing what, where. It's just no. And I'm not about to go through all that. Mm-mm. Yeah. It's done for.
So the going through phone shit, no. No. That shit might be for some of y'all, but that shit
like your friend
me.
Who do it for every nigga.
She, man, look, just I be telling be. Her, like, girl.
That's in her nature, just leave a be. That's her routine.
Stop doing that shit.
That is her nigga routine at this
like,
point.
Like, cause I'm like, bro, you lit. But my thing, I just don't, I honestly, my biggest pet peeve with the going through the phone shit is going through the phone to stay.
Yeah.
Go through that phone. If you gonna go through the phone, if you found what you didn't expect to find, or it ain't even what you didn't expect to find. You expected to find something. Mm-hmm. It, you know what I'm saying? You might just be a little surprised at what you find. But if you go through a phone and you get what you looking for, stop making yourself keep going through that. Because then in 3 more months, you're going to be going through the phone again.
Exactly.
To find the same shit.
Exactly. That's why.
That shit is dumb as fuck.
It's no point in staying.
It's not. It's no point. Like, if you fuck with a nigga who cheat on you that bad that you got to go through his phone every 3 months, let it go.
Why are y'all together? Let it go. Just break up.
Let it go. Love yourself, sis. Love yourself more, please. Because no, but yeah, so if best believe you want to go through my phone, we can swap. Go ahead, hand me that cellular device. Go ahead, I'll unlock it for you and everything. I'll even go to the messages if you want to. Mm-hmm. Hit go, but hand me that one. Thank you. Because let's not.
I think I'll still let it go through my phone. I won't go through his.
I
don't want to fucking see that shit.
I don't be giving a fuck.
I be seeing people make jokes like, I need to lose some weight. Let me go through this nigga phone real quick.
Oh, hell yeah. Y'all ask me depressed as fuck. No.
I promise you, going through somebody's phone not finna make me lose weight, because I'm finna be, once I see the bullshit,
I'm leaving you. I'm about to be outside.
I'm finna act the fuck up. Like, I'm leaving you and I'm finna turn up.
We about to have a good summer,
baby. I'm
finna
have a blast. Like, I ain't finna be fucking fat.
Right.
Hell no.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, so don't. Well, I mean, do it at your own discretion. Right. If you want to go through a nigga phone, that's on you. But don't, y'all, we too old to be going through phones and staying.
Right.
So, let's keep that in mind.
If you ain't got that trust in your relationship, just leave.
But yeah,
just
I feel like if you don't have trust in your relationship to the point where you got to go through their phone, you probably got your sign by even feeling like you gotta go through that phone.
Exactly.
Yeah. So, have fun with that shit.
Mm-hmm.
It is time that we shall leave you all. But before we do,
here's a little bit of love.
So, mine reads, the day you release the need to know every outcome and control every detail is the day you truly begin to savor and enjoy your journey.
Dang, that kind of tie into going through phones a little
bit. They do a little bit. Okay. Mine reads, be proud of yourself for all the darkness you went through, and despite it all, you're still standing.
Mm-hmm.
Remember that.
Mm-hmm.
That was a part of a little Bible study I had earlier this week, too.
Really?
It was something like that. Mm-hmm. It was like, God covered me in armor through all my trials and tribulations.
Yeah,
I'll still be standing.
I pray for protection all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that is all we have for you all today.
Hope you guys enjoyed this messy episode.
See you guys later.
Peace up. A-Town down.